Okay, hello Cloud Gurus, and welcome to my very first live feed. I've never done this before, and so I'm actually a little bit nervous because, believe it or not, sometimes it takes me a few takes to get things right on video. So I'm here today to talk about the Certified Solutions Architect Associate exam. Last week, we noticed that you could do a new exam called the Certified Solutions Architect Associate exam in beta. So I booked that for yesterday morning, did it at 8 a.m. and it's been very serendipitous timing because my Solutions Architect Associate normal one had expired, so I needed to recertify anyway. So I went and sat that exam again this morning. So I've done both exams within 24 hours of each other, so they're very fresh in my mind. Now, I will remind everyone that when you do these exams, you are under NDA, so I won't be able to get into specifics, but I can definitely give you an idea as to a very high level as to the differences between them. So I've got a whole bunch of questions here. I'm going to read them out, and then I'll tell you, what I think. So what exactly is a beta exam, and why are there beta exams? So Amazon will release a beta exam as a test, as a trial, and they'll get a certain number of people to take it. They don't release the results immediately, so when you go sit a beta exam, it can take anywhere from 6 to 12 weeks, depending on the exam, to get your results. And beta exams can be cancelled. So last year we had the security specialty exam at reInvent, and that was cancelled because they felt that the questions weren't up to standard of some of the other exams. The big data and the advanced networking went from beta into general availability, so you did get the results for that. A beta exam is a way of testing out new exam topics. What are the major differences between the current exam and the beta exam, and are there new topics covered? So that's a really interesting one. I actually thought the beta exam was slightly easier than the current exam. The current exam covers a lot of topics, but also goes into an awful lot of depth and will have very sort of long scenario questions. With the beta exam, it has a similar amount of breadth, but not as much depth, and the scenario questions are cleaned up. They're basically only going to be about two or three sentences long. They're a lot easier and quicker to read. So I actually enjoyed doing the beta exam more than the normal exam, but I did think it was a bit easier. And yes, there is a lot more breadth in my opinion. They do cover more topics than what was covered in the normal ones. But some of those topics can even just be what service, what would you use this service for? So it's just knowing the service. Should we, the ones who got Certified Solutions Architect Associate certified recently, take it again? So if you've just done your Solutions Architect Associate exam, it's definitely worth doing the beta exam. Go check it out. You will keep your current exam for the next 2 years from when you last pass it. So it's entirely up to you, especially if your employer is paying. Why not go have a crack at it? Will there be an update or differences course between the new and the old course? So absolutely, yes. I've already started filming it. I'm very agile. So we are right now in the production or in preparation for the Certified Cloud Practitioner. I am under a very tight deadline to get that out. I'm not going to tell you how tight, but we're talking very, very soon. And then I plan to have the new Certified Solutions Architect Associate ready just after that. In terms of timeframes, I think you could probably expect both out before reInvent. That's certainly what I'm aiming for. Let's see what else. What additional scope increase can we expect? Will there be more questions on S3, EC2, VPC? Will there be hands-on labs? Like I said, the beta covers more technologies, but in my opinion, a bit less depth. So there will be additional scope in the new course. We will cover technologies that aren't covered in the existing course, but some of those might just be theoretical lectures. But yes, there will definitely be lots of labs. The best way to learn AWS, as we all know, is to get our hands dirty. No one wants death by PowerPoint constantly. It's to go out and actually start playing with the technologies, and that's the fun way to learn. So what else is there? Let me just reading some questions. I'm taking the beta exam before it finishes. What are the new key topics I should learn? Again, NDA, can't really say, but I would definitely focus on a lot of the traditional technologies, The traditional technologies. Again, the course will cover what I think is the most important areas. Are there any advantages to taking the beta exam instead of the current one? To be honest, like I said, I think the beta exam is actually easier, so that is definitely an advantage. It was a lot more fun. The scenario questions were a lot more high level, but interesting. Like, there's different ways to solve the scenarios. The disadvantage to taking a beta exam is they might pull the beta, right? And who knows what happens. Like, that's what happened with the security architect, or so security specialty last year. So you might go do the exam, never find out if you pass, and then they pull the beta. So it's a risk. It's, good and bad. Let me scroll down. I'll be sitting the exam next month. Is it going to be based on the current blueprint or the updated one? So if you enrolled into the current solutions architect associate one, it's going to be based on the current blueprint. It's not going to be based on the beta blueprint, at least to my knowledge. It might be one for the AWS training and certification team as well. Again, we are a third party training company. So the way we discover everything is through the community as well. So it might be something you want to ask the training teams themselves. Let me have a look. What else is there? I've scheduled my exam already. Would current materials still apply? Absolutely. That's one thing I will say, is that you could do the our current course and you could expect to pass both exams. I think our current course covers enough, to pass both exams. Just scrolling down. Do you know if there's any plans to update any other associate exams? No, I don't. Again, that's one for the training and certification teams. Is there going to be a new course? If I purchase the old version, will I still have access to the new course? Let me figure that out, to be honest. There definitely is going to be a new course. Right now, the old course is enough to help you pass the new beta exam. There's not much of a gap between the two. We're still working on how we're going to package this. Obviously we want to be fair to our existing students who have already purchased the Solutions Architect Associate course. What is going to be the main differences between the old course and the new course? More labs, new topics? It's probably going to be a combination of both, actually. So more labs on things that we don't cover. One of the gaps, I think, we SSH into a lot of Linux instances. We don't really cover off Windows instances. And we want to cover both platforms as well. So maybe we'll go and create a web server using IIS instead of using Linux and Apache. Maybe we'll use Windows and IIS. But yes, there will be new labs, new topics, and lots more chances to learn new things. I recently passed the exam. Is my certification still current and valid? Absolutely, yes it is. Do I need to reset the exam if I just got certified recently? No, you don't. And again, this is my thoughts, but I'm pretty sure Amazon will come out and confirm this. There should hopefully be an announcement sometime soon. Their training and certification page have got, if you go to the training and certification page on the What's New, they say on there that they've got the certified cloud practitioner. So they've done a press release around that. I would expect that hopefully they're going to do something similar for the Certified Solutions Architect Associate in beta. How would you rate the beta exam and the existing exam from a difficulty perspective? So again, I'm speculating here, but what I think they're doing is they're taking all the easier questions from the current Solutions Architect Associate exam and they're putting it into the Cloud Practitioner. And then that allows people who, salespeople want to go out and get certified, people in marketing. There's a whole bunch of, occupations that work in cloud but have never got hands-on experience like SSHing or RDPing into servers. So they still want to go out and get certified. And currently, the only way they could do that is by doing the solutions architect or the developer. Now, certified cloud practitioners are helping to, basically bridge that gap, and you can go there and do that one first. So in my opinion or speculation, I think they're moving some of the easier questions down to certified cloud practitioner. Definitely the solutions architect associate beta exam is 100% scenario questions. It's just nonstop scenario questions. So that's quite interesting. Though to me, personally, I found it a bit easier than the recertification exam that I just did this morning. When do you anticipate the new exam to go live, and how do you plan on handling the transition in the AWS Solutions Architect Associate course through additional sections? I don't know, to be honest, when we anticipate the new exam to go live. I mean, Amazon do time things around reInvent, obviously. Maybe we'll have an announcement there. Maybe we'll have an announcement a couple of weeks before reInvent. Last year, the certified, the specialty exams were announced a couple of weeks before reInvent, and that got everyone sort of excited to go out and take the exams at reInvent. I would probably expect them to do something similar. reInvent, for those of you that don't know, is at the end of November, beginning of December, so we're only about 6 weeks out. And yeah, that looks like it for the questions. There's some live questions here. Let me have a look. So we've got Nicholas. When was the last updates to the SysOps and DevOps exams? When do you think they'd be updated? So to the exams, I don't know. SysOps, I basically 3 weeks ago, 2 weeks ago, finished because there's been a whole bunch of UI changes. So I've been updating those constantly. So they are definitely, our courses have been updated. I don't know when they last updated the exam contents. I have noticed that sometimes they'll use old terminology around things like storage gateway, for example, terminology that the product team doesn't call it by anymore. So you do have to go in knowing both sets of terminology. Please record this and add this somewhere for later viewing. I was late to the stream and now it's not playing at all. Don't worry, Bob. I'm just going to quickly turn you around. Here's our cameraman, Marcus, and Erica. So they are recording this for you and you'll be able to watch this on our YouTube channel as well. So I'm all out of questions. Thanks. Keep being awesome, Cloud Gurus, and I'll hopefully see you at reInvent or see you round at one of the summits. See you later. Bye.